The NCR's Homeland Security Strategic Plan is a long-term unified effort to strengthen our ability to prevent, protect, respond, and recover from terrorist attacks, major disasters, or other emergencies. To achieve this strategy, collaboratively developed solutions must be sustained to improve our preparedness as a region. Integrating the computer-aided dispatch systems of Alexandria, Arlington, and Fairfax is an example of providing better response to our shared residents using a standards-based approach that ensures interoperability throughout the region.
The birth of public safety radio communications interoperability was founded on January 13, 1982, in an event that occurred right in the metropolitan Washington area, commonly referred to as the crash of Air Florida Flight 90. You might remember seeing newscasts of that tragedy, wherein an airplane had attempted to take off from what was at that time National Airport in the midst of a blizzard and crashed onto the 14th Street Bridge, which spans the Potomac River and takes traffic from Washington, D.C. into Northern Virginia and particularly Arlington County, Virginia. That crash, by nature of when it occurred, how it occurred, and the response that it generated, pointed up a huge gap in the region's ability to communicate with each other, particularly during large metropolitan emergency events, and that occurred close to or on the border of different jurisdictions. On 9/11, a tragedy that is always in our minds, brought the radio interoperability to the absolute peak of its efficiency, because all of the units from the metropolitan Washington area that converged on the Pentagon that September morning were able to benefit from the radio operability that had preceded it and now is going to be complemented in the future by CAD to CAD interoperability on a routine, everyday basis. In Northern Virginia, we have had since the late 1960s a long-standing agreement wherein the cities of Alexandria, Arlington County, and Fairfax County shared their fire rescue and emergency medical service resources every single day, with the theory being that we wanted to dispatch the closest in-service available unit to an emergency occurred in any of those jurisdictions, and sometimes that response involved agencies from outside the jurisdiction in which the event would really occur in. Radio communications were completely enhanced by the advent of radio interoperability, but the ability through the CAD systems to effectuate that response, to assemble who were the right units to go, remained elusive.
The technology officials in the governments of the National Capital Region in Maryland, Virginia, and the District of Columbia worked jointly to develop a comprehensive regional communication strategy, the NCR Interoperability Program. The strategy included interconnection of existing local government high-speed fiber networks with dedicated capacity and high availability, and adoption of nationally recognized standards for data and information sharing through existing disparate systems.
Previously, the computer-aided dispatch, or CAD systems, recommended NOVA units for dispatch based upon a closest unit prediction. This method assumed that each unit was available and at its assigned station at all times. To make use of the units, the requesting jurisdiction utilized dedicated ring-down telephone lines to confirm unit availability and initiate the dispatch process. The Data Exchange Hub, or DEH, CAD-to-CAD exchange now provides interoperability between the CAD systems of Fairfax, Arlington, and Alexandria. The Unit Status Update Service provides the real-time status of all rescue units. The Request for Resource Service allows jurisdictions to electronically request those units from one another in mutual aid responses.
We started out with a valid operation requirement that everyone knew was technologically achievable. You put together the perceived value of interconnecting the INETs from various jurisdictions, and then a tremendous project management team, and an engaged customer, the public service entities, who really wanted to get this done. And when you put all that together, it turned into just a tremendous project.
The following scenario depicts an emergency that is taking place in Bailey's Crossroads. Since all nearby Fairfax units are out on other calls, the Fairfax dispatcher must request mutual aid units from neighboring Arlington and Alexandria.
Fairfax County 911, where is your emergency?
Hi, I think someone's having a heart attack.
Okay, where are you at?
The 911 call taker will continue to gather relevant incident information in order for fire dispatch to respond.
Is he having difficulty breathing or pain with breathing?
Yeah, he is. He was working out.
And is he having any chest pain?
Yeah, he's grasping at his chest and he's saying it's pretty sharp pain.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and get things started. We're coming out to fire.
The pending call for fire dispatch appears on the fire dispatcher screen. The ring down and CAD-to-CAD methods will now play out individually. Note the elapsed time for each method.
Alicia, I need Medic 206 and Engine 108.
Alexandria Fire Dispatch.
Yes, is Medic 206 available?
Medic 206, Channel 4 Bravo, Box 1097.
The Medic unit is being dispatched to the incident, and the fire dispatcher will continue to call for an Arlington resource.
Okay, Engine 108 is not available. However, Engine 107 is at Station 108. Would you like them instead?
Yep, that'll work.
All right, what kind of call?
It's for an ALS emergency with chest pain.
Box 1097 on Channel 4 Bravo for chest pain. 574 Main Street, Engine 107.
Medic 206, Engine 107, Channel 4 Bravo, Mutual Box 1097 for an ALS emergency, 574 Main Street.
Using the ring down method within the originating dispatch center, the status of the assigned units is now en route. This dispatch was completed within 90 seconds.
Medic 206, Engine 107, Channel 4 Bravo, Mutual Box 1097 for an ALS emergency, 574 Main Street.
Medic 206, Channel 4 Bravo, Box 1097, ALS emergency, 574 Main Street. Medic 206, Channel 4 Bravo, Mutual Box 1097.
The same commands were heard at the Arlington Fire Station, and now the fire engine is en route.
574 Main Street, Engine 107.
The CAD-to-CAD application has essentially eliminated the need for calls and follow-ups via phone between the dispatch centers. Now the information is on screen for the dispatcher, enabling instant awareness of what is available and the ability to request a mutual aid resource from another jurisdiction. Dispatchers are constantly aware of the status of local and mutual aid units, as those units are either dispatched, en route, or on scene to an incident.
The need for mutual aid often comes at the busiest times for a dispatcher. The CAD-to-CAD solution replaces a manual phone call procedure, substantially decreasing dispatcher workload when it is most crucial.
Good morning, sir. My name is Mike. I'm a paramedic with the fire department. Can you tell me what's going on this morning?
It's getting blue chest. It really hurts.
Okay, when did this start?
About 10 minutes ago or so.
Note the difference in time between the dispatch methods. This difference may have resulted in saving the victim's life.
Every second counts when there's an emergency. A heart attack patient needs intervention as fast as we can deliver it. Cutting response time to an incident is truly a survival multiplier for patients. The same holds true for structure fires. A fire can double in size every 60 seconds. Getting several engine companies on scene quickly is critical. It's crucial we dispatch the nearest and right resources to the fire ground immediately.
In Alexandria, 58% of structure fires and 100% of second alarm fires involve a mutual aid response from Arlington or Fairfax County. Since the CAD to CAD exchange went live, the median response time by mutual aid units has decreased by 1 full minute. In one instance, an Arlington medic unit was dispatched to an Alexandria incident involving a child not breathing within 20 seconds of Alexandria's units. This is unprecedented and a huge improvement for our system.
Interoperability is a process that involves planning, requirements, and communications with many public safety and non-public safety disciplines. By establishing common values, such as a bottom-up or practitioner-driven approach, and collaborative processes to share resources, the NCR can agree on common needs to support the interoperability vision.
The CAD-to-CAD project proves, once again, the collaborative nature of the relationships here in Northern Virginia. What we want to focus on next is three things: how we advance the unification of public safety communications and information sharing across the region, how we bring along people who perhaps don't operate in the same environment that we do, namely higher level decision makers and policy makers, get them to buy into the concept of a collaborative, unified regional effort. And then we also want to develop the governance structure that can help us to make decisions, choose the right investments, and have everybody very comfortable about how those decisions are made and why they are going along with the overall program and strategy for the wider region.
CAD interoperability, a cooperative, evolutionary process, not an isolated technology implementation. For more information, visit www.ncrnet.us.